was looking to say about Ty Horton and offense.
Well, we were struggling a little bit. You know, we had a real nice drive early with a nice touchdown catch of Deuce Watts, and then we got the big fumble recovery for a touchdown by Jaden Kennedy. And it was kind of our defense was kind of wore out, and the offense needed to make some plays. And down there at the very end, they did. You just never know when it's your opportunity. You know, and it was Kai's opportunity. I've been telling him. Tell all those guys, you know, you're two plays away from getting in there and playing if you're 13. Sure enough, that's what happened.
But Tajay Spears showing a lot of versatility tonight. What did you see from him, and how important was it to have a running back that you can use out of the backfield and the traditional role and then on trick plays and one?
Well, he also had a really, really nice block on a big blitz pickup and the first down at Deuce on our drive for the touchdown. So he's a complete player. You know, he can run inside, he can run outside. He'll block people. He catches the ball, smart, you know. So he's a, you know, he's a difference maker kind of guy. We need to try to get the ball in his hands as much as we can.
Michael Pratt was sidelined tonight, but he seemed pretty involved with the entire team. Went out for the coin toss in overtime. What can you say about him as a person? How involved was he tonight with doing everything with stuff?
He's just awesome, good man. You know, I would expect nothing less from him. That's just the way he was raised, the way he operates, and. You know, that's how you're supposed to. It's a team game. You know, I tell these guys all the time, you're not going to be rooting for your buddies getting into MMA fighting, right?
Can you talk about it immediately or what his prognosis is?
I think he'll be ready next week.
Is he armed?
Undisclosed injury.
He called timeout on the Griffin ball play. Was that the gym supposed to dial that up, or what was it?
Well, the offensive staff was talking about it, and we just, we had a couple of them that we weren't sure of. You know, it's a play. If it's not there, we go ahead and roll out. And you know, it's all based on reading the end. And, you know, it's kind of a goal line play that everybody's running nowadays. And the end went up the field. And Kai did a good job reading him, pitched to Tyreek, and Tyreek scored a touchdown.
Did you consider going for two at all in that situation?
Just a little too much time. If there would have been 15 seconds, we would have been going for two, but I think it was 39 seconds left. And, you know, they could still get down the field and do some stuff. So we didn't, you know, we knew if we kicked it, and they probably played for overtime, I thought, but they kind of were aggressive for a little while.
It's kind of a tough place for you guys to go. What would it say that you were able to get it done?
Well, I just thought, you know, everybody kept believing on the sideline, and you know, the defense, you know, just kept. You just don't know the path to victory. It changes, you know, all the time, and the defense was just playing lights out, and I'm just glad the defense had enough toughness and grit not to get discouraged by how we were playing offensively. And they kept saying, hey, we're gonna score the points. And then and the offense started clicking that last drive, and we were real close on a bunch of plays too. I you know, there's a few plays I thought we were pretty close on.
Clayton Toon was projected to be a first rounder ahead of this season, and it's been hard for defense to stop him. You guys said what exactly went into stopping him?
You know, I really thought we had a good game plan. And for the most part, we corralled him because he likes to get outside the pocket, do some stuff. And we covered. We had to cover for a long time. But he's a fine quarterback. He really is. And I just thought Coach Hampton and the defensive staff had a heck of a game plan, and the kids executed.
Yeah, 42 plays for Houston in the second half of year 13, but when it came all the time.
Yeah, they were wore out. You know, they eked out a few first downs, you know, but they played well. I thought we tackled pretty good most of the time. Played leverage. There's some times, you know, you thought, hey man, they're gonna get a big rip, and the guys did a good job of approaching with leverage.
Shoulder done?
You know, it's a shoulder. I'm not sure. We're gonna find out here. He couldn't go back in. He's very disappointed.
You talked a little bit about Kai Horton, but what can you say about his ceiling? He looked really good as far as ball placement goes, but just as far as his development.
You know, I thought he did some good stuff. You know, he was, you know, there's a few balls he'd probably like to have back, but for coming into a pressure pack situation like this, I thought he did a whale of a job. Pretty good.
Recording stopped.